Does it have to be? Ooh. Okay, well, I don't think I'll use that for ambient much, but... Okay, I'm going to try putting steps into the volt per octave. Ooh, you can. Okay, day one. My plan today is to go through a YouTube tutorial, make a basic patch, and hopefully learn some of the basics for subtractive synthesis in Eurorack, and that should be good for today. So here I am building my first patch in VCV Rack, and I was following two YouTube tutorials, one from Red Means Recording and one from Venus Theory. I'll link them below, they were both really good. And I was just learning here which modules I needed to start with, kind of what they do. Here I was kind of struggling with the audio module. I really didn't understand that it wasn't a mixer, and that the outputs on the bottom are actually the inputs on my audio interface. And the inputs on the top are the outputs on my audio interface. So I just could not figure out how to connect things and hear them in my headphones and record them in the recording module. It was definitely something I spent the first day working a lot on. Okay, day two. It's actually been a few days and I reviewed the footage from last time and realized that the internal synthesizer sounds were not recording. I could hear them in my headphones, but they were not recording. So I'm going to make a similar subtractive synthesis today and maybe get a little more fancy with it, add some filters. That's my plan. Okay, this is feeling familiar. I know the gate goes in... Oh yeah. It is kind of nice building a similar thing. Felt a little more confusing last time. And then this goes to the filter. Nope. Wait, why not? Oh yeah, I can. Ooh. Okay, well, I don't think I'll use that for ambient much, but... I wonder what the other waves sound like. Kind of the same. I wonder how you would tune this to be an octave down. 261, that's so random. Does it have to be? Like, can I make it 200? Okay. Kind of more the sound I wanted. Okay, this makes me happy. It's really all I wanted. Okay, day three. The first thing I want to try today is using a sequencer. And I have heard that an LFO works well as a clock source. So I'm going to use one of those. Okay, I'm going to try putting steps into the volt per octave. We'll see, maybe that's the right thing to do. Oh, we have sound. I'm not really sure how this is making sound. I wonder if that's wrong. Well, you know that's wrong. I mean, maybe. Just seems like it's not working. Now, why would this change the pitch? Okay, I'm going to try putting steps into the volt per octave. Something's wrong here. Okay, well, that's working. So confusing. Okay. I think I may have figured this part out. I think this can control up to three voices. Okay, I think it's working. Really quiet, though. And how are you supposed to tune these? Oh, you know what? I think I know how I can... Isn't there a quantizer? Okay. And the output goes... Okay, this is working, maybe. Okay. C major. Okay. This actually kind of sounds more like drums than anything. OK, okay. I mean, it's going to be the same 8 steps over and over again. I'm sure there's a way to make that more interesting, but I'm happy with this. So many things to follow. I almost might start over and make a whole new patch. Day 4, and today I want to focus on modulating sounds to make more interesting sounds. Okay, I've just grabbed some modules that I think I might want to use, and I'm going to start making a basic patch. This has gotten easier, but I think it'll still be a while before it feels really intuitive. It is a bit of trial and error. Well, that's fun. Okay, I'm gonna get a scope. Wish I could move everything down, but... Ooh, you can. Okay. I still don't even fully know how you would use this, but... Oh, yeah, okay. Oh. I understand it's frequency modulation, I just don't understand what it's doing to the wave that makes it do that. Okay. I like the sound. Get this in multiple sources in. Okay, there we go. Okay, well, let's output that and see what we get. Oh, great. This I'm still figuring out. Just needs a trigger. Thank you. really did need that. What if I just use the same square wave? Oh, yeah. I wonder how we could change which notes are played, or if there's a way to change that rhythm. There you go. And I kind of want to add a delay to fill in the blank. Oh, perfect. This is kind of exactly what I was hoping for today. Okay, day five, the last day of the challenge. Today I want to see if I can make a more complicated patch with a few sound sources. Okay, I just grabbed some modules I think I'll want to use and tried to organize them so I'm not covering up any modules with my face. Oops. I'm actually going to use this clock to run these two in. I'm hoping that that will put them more in time. And they are not in time. It doesn't seem to be working. But that did. Nice, okay. And that's it. I'm really happy with how this challenge went. I feel like I learned a lot. If you're interested in getting into modular synthesis, I would definitely recommend VCV Rack. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.